Most expected legal general knowledge questions for the law entrance exams. Okay, welcome back friends. In this video, we will cover important legal general knowledge questions which are important for your CLAT exams, law entrance text of Delhi University, LLB, LLM and BA LLB exams like of the IP University, Jamia Millia Islamia and other universities. So let us start some important questions which may appear in your upcoming exams. So let us start. The very first is per inquirium, which means a mistaken decision. Sometimes whenever the court is going to pass any decision, there may be some error or mistake apparent on the face of record. So this mistake in the decision is called per inquirium, which can be rectified later on. Next is called a trefoil convict. For example, a person who has been convicted for a commission of an offense in the previous case, and now in the next case he appears before the court. So when the court determines that the person has been formally convicted in the previous case, the terminology is called a trefoil convict. Now moving on to the next part, which is called lexi loci, which is called law of a place. For example, in India, we have our municipal law in consonance with all the international treaties like Unicentral Model, treaties like TRIPS, okay, and UN Organization, Universal Declaration of Human Rights, so 1948. So we have our laws which has been borrowed from the common law of England. Most of the part has been taken from the common law of England, but time to time, since independence, Indian judiciary had played an active role and rectified, amended the laws as per the need of India. Okay, so lexi loci means law of a place. Now, list pendens, which means a pending suit. Sometimes whenever case is filed before a court and over a period of time we have no any kind of decision over it, so this type of suit is called list pendens or a pending suit. Fox pass, which is called tactless mistake. It is also very important. Now the bona vacantia means goods that have no owner. Sometimes there are good, but there is no owner to claim right over it. So this is what called the bona vacantia. In pari delicto, it is also very important where both the parties to a dispute are equal at fault. Sometimes plaintiff A comes before the court pertaining to any dispute, and the defendant B also comes, okay, in his defense, but the court finds or determines that both party A and B are equally at fault. So this terminology is called pari delicto. Now pari passu, which means on equal footing. Jus gentium means law among nation. This terminology will come when you will study during your course of LLB, when you will study the public international law or private international law. Punctum temporis means a point of time. Turpis arbiter means a corrupt judge. Okay, caveat vendictor, which means seller beware. And when the caveat emptor comes, then there is a buyer's beware. Okay, now the next question is sine die, which means adjourn without fixing any date for the next meeting. Okay, important one. Animus possidendi, which means intention to possess. Malus animus, which means a bad intention or a malified intention. Sometimes when a plaintiff A appears before the court, okay, he just want to inflict, or he want to inflict B, who is an innocent person, in a case. In such case, and there is a collusion or the malified intention of A, which is called malus animus. The next is called alibi, which means a plea by an accused person that he was present elsewhere. For example, A has been inflicted, or there is a case against A regarding a murder. So how he will prove? He can prove that, for example, the commission of murder was in Kolkata, but at the time of the commission of the offense, Mr. A was in Delhi. So Mr. A can give certain proofs as to he was in Delhi when there was a commission of an offense. okay, by means of presenting some ticket, okay, or by railway ticket, or by means of hotel receipt, or anything. So this plea or evidence which he provides to before the court regarding his innocence, or that he was present elsewhere and he has not committed that offense, is called alibi or the plea of alibi. The next question is, under the Constitution of India, the restriction on the freedom of the religion can be placed on the ground are social justice. Very important question, this question appeared in the law entrance exam of Delhi University and even in the civil judge exam of Uttar Pradesh and Madhya Pradesh, it appeared so many times. So you just remember, the social justice is the ground on which the India, on which the restriction can be imposed on the freedom of religion. If an authority is holding information about another in a fiduciary capacity, the information under the Right to Information Act 2005 may not be obtainable. So the question here is, what do you mean by the fiduciary relationship in the present context? So first important point here is that a fiduciary relationship is nothing but a relationship of trust. There are certain examples like lawyer and client, doctor and patient, teacher and students. In all these three cases, one person should not the confidential information of the other in the public. Okay, so there is a trust. Okay, trust. So this is called relationship of trust or the fiduciary relationship. Okay, the next question is, which of the following is not a directive principle of the state policy under part 4 of the Constitution of India? The first very important question is, what is the DPSP of the part 4 of the Indian Constitution? So as we know, the fundamental right given in part 3rd, the DPSPs are in part 4. Fundamental rights are justiciable, whereas DPSPs are not justiciable. What is the reason why the DPSPs are not justiciable? The reason is, to provide you any welfare, any facility, any kind of health facility, education, promotion of any welfare policy, okay, to promote education, to promote any kind of social welfare policy in the state, what is required is the resource. If there is a lack of resource, how can a state provide you these facilities or these kind of, you know, these welfare policies? So resource is the very important factor or the parameter here. If the state do not have the resources, the state cannot help you. So now the important question is that why we cannot knock the door of the court? Because the state is not under the obligation. So if there is an infringement of DPSP, the active principle of state policies enshrined in part 4, you cannot go to the courts of law. Whereas in the case of part 3rd or the fundamental right, whenever there is an infringement of fundamental right, you can knock the door, and there are so many fundamental rights enshrined in the part 3rd. Okay, like for example, freedom of speech and expression, right to move freely, right to have trade of your own choice, and so many others. So we will discuss it in another video. So here in this question, it is mentioned which of the following is not a directive principle of the state policy. So first of all, you go to the Bayer Act and study the part 4, and you will find that nowhere the promotion of adult education, adult education is written. Okay. When you will see the DPSP, you will find that a state has duty to promote the education or health facilities, but 6 to 14 years of the age, not the adult one. Okay, so now moving on to the next part, audi alteram partem. This is very important maxim, which means giving opportunity of hearing of the other side. So hearing, audi alteram partem, yaad rakhna hai aapko. Which of the following was described by Dr. B.R. Ambedkar as the heart and soul of the Constitution of India? It's a very simple question, and you might have seen this question so many times in the previous papers. So right to constitutional remedies, Article 32, when we go to the Supreme Court, we approach the Supreme Court, okay, we file a PIL under Article 32, knocking the door of the apex court, honorable apex court in India, that is the honorable Supreme Court. So under Article 32, we go to the Supreme Court. Under Article 226, we knock the door of the Honorable High Court. So these are the right to constitutional remedies, Article 32. Okay. Obiter dicta means, okay, one most important question. I have already mentioned that Article 226 and Article 32. So under Article 32, only for the fundamental right infringement, you can knock the door of the Honorable Supreme Court. But in the case of Article 226, High Court, Honorable High Court, you can knock whenever there is an infringement of your fundamental right as well as your legal right. So here what we can conclude that the Article 226 is wider than Article 32. Got it? It's very important question, friends. Mere dimag mein aaya, so I have mentioned before you. Now moving on to the next part, which is called obiter dicta, means an opinion given by the court not necessary for a decision. Under the Constitution of India, right to pollution free environment has emerged as a fundamental right. From the right to it's very important, right, to have a pollution free environment. And as we know, recently we have seen that the Honorable Supreme Court banned the crackling in Delhi, Diwali, and so many other measures have been taken by the PIL filed by the honorable person, that is MC Mehta, in case of Ganga pollution and so many other cases. So we find that and even the PIL filed in the case of Narmada Bachao Andolan, and so many cases are there. So protection of the environment. So this is what it is enshrined under Article 21, that is right to life and personal liberty. So you have right to have the pollution free environment. Okay. So under Article 21, important article this is very important article. Now persona non grata means an unacceptable person. Very important. The object of which of the following writ is to prevent a person to hold public office which he is not legally entitled to hold. So quarento. So there are five types of writs. We will discuss. We will make it a separate video on the writs. But for the purpose of this video, we're just going to discuss this question. So the quarento is the correct, option. Okay. So person to hold a public office. Yeah, it's very important. Please keep it in your mind. Quarento. Which of the following does not belong to the right to freedom of religion? Okay. Now we find that the right to freedom of religion, freedom of speech and expression. Why actually there is a reason behind it. So whenever you claim any right against right to freedom of religion. So first of all, subject to the public health, morality or public order, the state can impose a reasonable restriction. Okay. So there are so many cases in the Indian judiciary, race, turn list, and so many cases like, a national anthem case and other cases are there, which when we find that for in the, the fundamental rights are not absolute, they are subject to the, reasonable restrictions. So this is the one example I have given. So here freedom of speech and expression, you cannot just, these are the, this is something which does not belong to the right to freedom of religion. It is important. You need to focus on the part third, complete part third. And when you will read it from the book like Lakshmikant, very important book, you can buy the Lakshmikant. I will mention the link also, and I will be explaining certain important topics from the Lakshmikant, and it is very important, for the constitutional law. Okay. Now next question is the lis pendens, which means a pending suit. Now which Indian state had prescribed minimum education qualification for candidate contesting panchayat role? Recently we find that Haryana has prescribed a minimum educational qualification for candidate contesting panchayat role. Very important question, friends. So it could appear in this 2019 CLAT exam or other law entrance exam. Please note it down somewhere else. Now as per law, a minimum age for the marriage of a boy and a girl in India, okay, so 21 is for the boy and 18 years for the girl. The Supreme Court of India has struck down the Constitution 99th Amendment 2014 as unconstitutional. And it relates to what? So National Judicial Appointment Commission, nothing much. You can better understand. It is very well known. Okay. National Judicial Appointment Commission. Appointment of judges. Regarding the appointment of the judges. Now, some important questions which can come in the recent exams, let us see. Those are, who of the following is the chancellor of the Nalsar University of Law located in Hyderabad? So you know, have the Chief Justice of Andhra Pradesh High Court. Actually, this is something which is a which is in the current affairs, and you need to update your current affairs by news, while you know, why, by reading the newspapers like the Hindu, Indian Express, or the Times of India. So unless and until you will regularly keep watching these you know, current affairs, you will miss this question, these questions. Okay, so these options may change accordingly. So for the purpose of the examination, you need to update yourself what is current in news. Okay, so please you should be very much proactive regarding it. Now moving on to the next one. Who is the legal advisor of the government of the state in India? So the Advocate General, legal advisor to the government of state of India. Yaad rakhna hai aapko. Okay, state in India. Now, which of the following issue did D.D. Basu versus state of West Bengal deals with? So D.D. Basu versus Jaisehi, it's very important case regarding the safeguard of the arrested person or the detained person. So very important case. So many times I have seen it, this question so many times in the so many papers. So just keep it in your mind that it is a safeguard for the arrested person. The age of retirement of the judge of the High Court in India is 62 years. Okay. Friends, you can also watch my other videos in the playlist regarding the current affairs and the judgments I have uploaded, and please subscribe my channel also, because so that I can and press the bell icon, because I can update you regarding the contemporary legal changes or issues which are in the current affairs. Okay, so now moving on to the next part. In the law, the term neighbor means a people who might be affected by your actions. So yeah, aapko yaad rakhna hai in law what it means. This question is important, may appear in your CLAT exam. In which of the following case did the Supreme Court direct the compulsory registration of marriage in India? Seema versus Ashwini Kumar. Friends, first of all, this judgment is very important, and Seema versus Ashwini Kumar, you must know, because ultimately this question is a important judgment of the Indian judiciary regarding the registration of the marriages in India. So you must know that the case name is Seema versus Ashwini Kumar. This will definitely come in, so in your exam, so please mark it or as important. Which of the following principle is applicable for the purpose of reducing multiplicity of the proceedings? Res judicata. So res judicata section 11, agar hum padhenge, where of the civil procedure code, we find that provision of the res judicata is there. So we will discuss it later on in the separate video when we will upload the civil procedure code. So this is res judicata. Okay, which of the following is the best described the legal phrase animus curiae, a friend of the court? You know, there are so many cases when we find that there is some person who assists the court. The duty of that person is to assist the court, providing or facilitating the procedure regarding the disposal of case at faster pace. So such person is called amicus curiae, or the friend of the court. Such person is appointed by the court. Okay, now in which of the following case did Supreme Court for the first time lay down the fundamental right to have primacy over the directive principle of the state policy? So Minerva Bill versus Union of India. When you will read the judgments in my video, in my playlist, that is video which I have uploaded, you will find these important judgments and their ratios. Okay, recently I am also working on the detailed version of each case, and I will provide the detailed ratio and decision and facts of the cases on my channel. Okay, so Minerva Mill versus Union of India. Fundamental right have primacy over the DPSPs. Okay, part 3rd over part 4. Now, which of the following writ can be issued against a person believed to be holding a public office he is not entitled to hold? Earlier, we have already done, that is quo warranto, important writ. Which of the following is entrusted with the statutory duty of laying down the standard of profession, conduct, and etiquette of for the advocate in India? So, you know, there is a Bar Council of India, and the Bar Council of India, when you will read the advocacy and ethics, you will find that there are so many judgments where there are certain rules laid down by the Bar Council of India. Here we find that professional conduct is to be maintained, a standard professional conduct is to be maintained by the practicing lawyers or advocates in India. So the Bar Council of India, very important question. A person has designed a new type of scissors for cutting of the cloth, scissors for cutting of the cloth, under which act he can seek the protection of his invention? So now this is a scissor. Okay, so as I have already mentioned in the very beginning, protection in India. So for example, there is a copyright infringement. So we have the Copyright Act 1957, we have the Patent Act 1970, Trademarks Act, Farmer Rights, okay, Breeder, Geographical Indications, okay. So we have and trade secret laws. So these are the copyright laws, and our law, the municipal law of India, is in consonance with the Paris Convention, okay, Madrid Convention, Bonn Convention, and the TRIPS, trade related aspect of intellectual property rights, WIPO, World Intellectual Property Organization. So these are the regarding the intellectual property rights. After completing your LLB, you can go for the LLM, and particularly in the field of intellectual property rights, you can pursue your LLM. I have completed my LLM in corporate law as well as in the intellectual property rights. Okay, now let us move forward. Which of the following law deals with the intellectual property protection for the horticulture product? As I have already mentioned in my previous sentence, that the Protection of Plant Variety and Farmer Right Act. Okay, very important. Name which, now match the following here, the writs and their meanings. So habeas corpus means you may have the body, so bring the body before the court, okay, present karna. So habeas corpus. The second is called mandamus, which means we command. So mandamus means whenever any department is not, authority is not doing any work, the court can give the command to perform that duty. Okay, now certiorari. Certiorari means to be certified. Very important, as the name certified, certiorari, you can correlate. Now the coverento. Coverento means by what authority you are holding the position. So you can match the following. This is very important. I think this will cover all the important dates here. By means of this, match the following. Okay, now who among the following was the first person to be directly appointed as judge of the Supreme Court? So Kuldeep Singh. This is very important question, friends, and it appeared in the UP civil judge exams also. This question appeared in the UP civil judge exam, so this could also be as far as your CLAT exam is concerned, this question could come as a current affairs. Okay, now the next question is, what is the maximum time limit for filing a complaint before the consumer dispute redressal forum from the date when the cause of action arises? So within the period of 2 years, whenever there is any dispute regarding there is a consumer dispute, for example, you have purchased a refrigerator and the refrigerator is not working well, or there is air condition which is not properly functions. So in such case, you can move to the consumer protection. In case dealer or any company you want the claim, so you have to file that case before the consumer dispute redressal forum within 2 years. Okay, this is the time limit prescribed, okay, under the present act, Consumer Dispute Act, COPRA, Consumer Protection Act. Now, under which of the which law a minor is incapable of entering into contract? So Indian Contract Act 1872, okay, minor, Dharmoda, Mori BB versus Dharmodas, very important judgment, please ise mark kare, very important case. Which of the following it is said to be the guarantor of personal freedom? Habeas corpus. Okay, so habeas corpus is the guarantor of personal freedom. Also, one important question: in which of the following writ the res judicata does not apply? The habeas corpus. Okay, very important question. It also appeared in the civil judge exam. This is the reason I'm telling you. Habeas corpus means habeas corpus, the bulwark of the constitution, you can say. Now, which of the following is the oldest high court in India? High Court of Calcutta, very important question. Again, in the MP Civil Judge exam, this was one of the questions. So I have mentioned it here. The power to issue writ has been envisaged under the provision of which of the following fundamental right? Right to constitutional remedy. Okay, power to issue writs, Article 32. Also, one more important article, that is Article 226. I have already mentioned above. So regarding the writ before the Honorable High Court for infringement of fundamental right as well as legal right, and the fundamental right, Article 32. Okay, before the Honorable Supreme Court. Now, rule of law means all the persons are equal in the eye of law. Very important. Very simple. Which of the following act writ can be issued to force a public authority to perform a public or statutory duty? Mandamus. We have already done it before. Mandamus means a mandatory duty. Whenever an authority or a public duty or a public authority do not perform any kind of duty, any kind of legal duty, then you can go to the court and court will issue a writ, that is mandamus, to that authority to perform its duty. In which of the following landmark judgment did the Supreme Court of India lead out the guidelines against sexual harassment of women at workplace? It is very important question, friends. Definitely, this will appear in your upcoming exam. So, Vishakha versus State of Rajasthan. Okay, certain guidelines have been laid down here, and the regarding the sexual harassment of the women at the workplace. Very important judgment, friends. Please mark it as an important and pen it down somewhere else. Now, the marriage of a 15 years old girl with a 45 years old man is a what? Void or voidable. So, or valid. So, the option is voidable at the option of girl. So, whenever there is a marriage between 15 years girl or 45 years of man, then it is voidable at the option of girl or the other party, that is girl. Okay. So voidable means at the option of other party. So voidable at the option of girl. Got it? Now, what does the legal term caveat emptor refers to? So already I have mentioned above. So let the buyer beware. So whenever you go to the shop and purchase any goods, it is your duty first to see whether the good is in good condition, whether it is working or functioning well as prescribed in the instructions. So it is the duty of the buyer. So buyer beware means caveat emptor. It is important. Who was the first woman judge to be appointed to the Supreme Court of India? So Justice, the Honorable Justice, the Shrimati M. Fatima Bibi. So very important question. Okay. And who was the first woman judge to be appointed Chief Justice of High Court? Honorable Justice Shrimati Leela Seth. Now, the next question, in which of the following case did Supreme Court allow the passive euthanasia under exceptional circumstances? Anurag Shanbag versus Union of India. This is very important judgment. This is very important judgment, friends. You can go to the judgment in the playlist of my channel where you will find this judgment, and it is very important question. Please mark it as important because it will definitely come in your Anurag versus Union of India will definitely come in your exam regarding the passive euthanasia. You know what do you mean by the euthanasia? So whenever there is a exceptional circumstances and the person is in a persistent vegetative state or not able to recover and for a longer period of time, so a chief medical officer after complete analysis in presence of the close relative or the person of such person, so not the friend but relative of such person, can give the passive euthanasia so that person soon will die. Okay, because there is a no use to keep in pain such patients, so we need to it is better to relieve. Okay, it is better to relieve. So passive euthanasia under the Aruna versus Union of India, please, it's very important. Now, the what is the total number of high court in India? The 24 high courts are there. And now the next question is Andaman and Nicobar Island comes under the jurisdiction of which of the following high court? So Calcutta High Court. So wherever whatever the cases appears in the generate in the Andaman's Island, so the case will go to the Calcutta High Court. So jurisdiction of which court? Calcutta High Court. Okay. Now Sharda Act deal with child marriage, important one. Which of the following is credited with the drafting of Indian Penal Code 1860? This question is very important for the LLB exams in the Delhi University. So I appeared and I have found this question in 2014. I think it was there. So the Lord Macaulay, very important question. In which of the following judgment, the constitutional bench of the Supreme Court of India, Honorable Supreme Court of India, mentioned the rarest of rare principle and in the award of the death penalty was first laid down in which case? Bachchan Singh versus State of Punjab, 1980. So when during your law LLB course, when you will read the criminal laws, specifically the Indian Penal Code IPC, you will find that the Bachchan Singh, this is very landmark judgment, Bachchan Singh versus State of Punjab. So here the rarest of rare principle was laid down by the Honorable Supreme Court. Okay, the next question is in which of the following case the constitutional validity of the Muslim Women Protection of Right of Divorce Act 1986 was upheld by the Supreme Court. So the option is Daniel Latif versus Union of India. Friends, along with this video, I will prescribe you to please watch the judgment video of on my channel, and you can update the current affairs also on my channel. And not every day, but on weekly basis, definitely I will or monthly basis I will put the current affairs or the important judgment video on my channel. So please subscribe and press the bell icon so that whenever I will upload any content, that should reach. So okay friends, so thank you very much for watching this video. All the best and God bless to all of you.